They call us now before they but drop the bombs. The phone rings and someone who knows my first name calls and says in perfect Arabic, "This is David." And in my stupor of sonic booms and glass-shattering symphonies still smashing around in my head, I think, do I know any Davids in Gaza? They call us now to say, run. You have 58 seconds from the end of this message. Your house is next. They think as if of some kind of wartime courtesy. It doesn't matter that there's nowhere to run to. It means nothing that the borders are closed and your papers are worthless and mark you only for a life sentence in this prison by the sea. And the alleyways are narrow and there are more human lives packed one against the other more than any other place on earth. Just run. We aren't trying to kill you. It doesn't matter that you can't call us back to tell us the people we claim to want aren't in your house, that there's no one here except you and your children who were cheering for Argentina, sharing the last loaf of bread for this week, counting candles left in case the power goes out. It doesn't matter that you have children, you live in the wrong place, and now is your chance to run to nowhere. It doesn't matter that 58 seconds isn't long enough to find your wedding album, or your son's favourite blanket, or your daughter's almost completed college application, or your shoes, or to gather everyone in the house. It doesn't matter what you had planned, it doesn't matter who you are. Prove you're human, prove you stand on two legs, run.
Jana Bilal Abu Kawada. 1. Female. Sabreen Muhammad Abu Kawada. 32. Female. Yazan Ahmad Abu Kawada. 4. Male. Ahmad Karim Al Samari. 2.
The more we can isolate the Israeli propaganda, the edifice which keeps it propped up will start to crumble. It's a small gesture, but we want to make them know. As we said at the weekend, Charlie Flanagan, our Minister for Foreign Affairs, said that only in exceptional circumstances can an ambassador be removed. But we have already crossed the threshold. We've gone beyond the threshold of what's exceptional circumstances. So we ask him to back it up now. Where is his courage? Where is the humanity? The people of Ireland, we're showing where our courage and where our humanity is. We want a concrete action. We want this man removed from our country. And that is the first step. As we said, we've other plans. The boycott's going to keep going. We're going to keep mobilising. We're going to keep pressurising the politicians. You know, but to be silent, and we aren't being silent, to be silent is to condone these war crimes. As Desmond Tutu said, if you're neutral during times of oppression, you are taking the side of the oppressor.
Tuqa Salah Abu Isa. 1. Female. Muhammad Riyad Abu Jaber. 77. Male.
I mean, we know that we need to get it out there that whether or not the bombardment continues, and restarts in the next few days, depending on the outcome of the negotiations in Cairo, the crime against the Palestinian people and against the people of Gaza is continuing nonetheless. Yes. There is a low-level war going on all the time against the people of Gaza and against the people of Palestine. Their land is being stolen, they are being besieged, they are being starved, they are being strangled, they are being slowly murdered by the Israeli regime, by the apartheid regime, and by the cruel and brutal and ongoing siege of Gaza. So our battle cannot just be from one crisis to another. It has to sustain itself during the periods when the media ignores, consider other issues to be more important, when the politicians stop talking about it. That is the only way we are going to force the hand of our government and other governments to impose the sanctions, the divestment, the breaking off of diplomatic and political and trade relations with Israel that will be necessary to finally bring justice to the Palestinian people. And there's a particular word that they use about us, the people who don't just come out for the big atrocities. They call us the delegitimizers. This is the term that Israel uses. And it's a very accurate term, because it's one thing for them to have to deal with occasional mobilizations against this or that atrocity. But what they fear most are the people who say, no, 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 this isn't just about this or that assault on Gaza. Israel is a dysfunctional, racist, apartheid state that needs to be internationally isolated and dismantled. That is what they fear more than anything else.
Rital Taysir Abu Hawada, 1, female. Ibrahim Karim Abu Samira, 9, male. Ada Rafat Abu Khadir, 14, male.